As you can clearly see, I'm at a more higher quality. I apologize if you hear water running in the background, but that's my fish tank. Well, it's not my fish tank, it's my father's fish tank. If it was up to me, I would unplug it. Our goldfish is over... it's over 10 years old. It should be dead by now. But, you know, the stupidity when it comes to certain universities, it's outstandingly stupid on how things can get. I'm like, does this really need to be a thing? I mean, I shouldn't have to make a video about this sort of topic, because something like this is not necessary. And yet here I am, making a video on something that is this fucking stupid. I mean, holy fucking shit. I might as well show you guys the video, not the video, but the article. Because you guys knew what you were getting yourself into. You guys knew that the moment you click on this video, you knew that there was something stupid going on. And I'm about to show you. You're curious on how this exists. Huh. There's a link down in the description. You can take a look for yourself. And, you know, I'm going to make a video about this because it baffles me that we gunned this fucking low thanks to social justice warriors.
University student is ordered not to pull up her hand to ask questions because she would be violating her classmates' safe space.
Yeah, that's a thing, ladies and gentlemen. That's a fucking thing.
A student was almost kicked out of a meeting after she violated a safe space by raising her arm at Andred University. Amora Wilson wanted to make a point at Thursday's student council session when she was told off by officials. The vice president for academic affairs at the University Student Association was accused of failing disabled students by not responding in an open letter. She immediately raised her arm to disagree, but was made subject of a ludicrous complaint and told not to make that gesture again. Imogen was also warned for shaking her head during the meeting as it again breached the safe space, which the part of the University Student Association rules. She told the Huffington Post, "I raised my arms in disagreement as we had contacted the writers of the letter and tried hard to organize a meeting. It was made for that reason that a safe space complaint was made. Student Association policy says that council members should be respectful and considerate. Section 6C of the safe space policy is defined as refraining from hand gestures which denote disagreement or in any way other indicating disagreements with a point or points being made. Disagreement should only be evident during the normal course of debate. A vote took place to decide whether Emoji should be removed from the meeting after she was accused of breaking the rules."
How dare you have an opinion? How dare you disagree with us by raising your hand? I've never heard of someone feel violated for just simply raising their hand. I mean, what? Does someone raising their hand somehow remind you of, back in the 1940s, where, like, World War II started and, you know, Adolf Hitler was saluted by, you know, people just raising their hands like, "Say hey!" Is that it? I mean, holy shit! Imagine these sort of people working at jobs like St. McDonald's or Family Dollar. These people are the most unstable group of people I have ever met. The fact of the matter is that they created a safe space, you know, for people who get triggered by people raising their heads and shaking their head in disagreement. I mean, the level of narcissism is amazing! These things are not safe spaces. These are fucking echo chambers. If you can't even have a disagreement within that facility, then it's not really much of a safe space. It's a fucking echo chamber. It's just, you know, one mindset. You know, if you think outside that mindset, you're not welcome there. You know, even if it's just slightly different, it has to be exactly the same. And you expect me to believe that feminism or social justice, it's not a freaking hive mind where everyone thinks exactly the same. I'm sorry, but the more I see something like this, the more it compels me to believe that feminism and social justice is not about individuality, but rather to become one. A freaking hive mind. And you know, some of the students are actually very pissed about this because they're realizing that their university is turning into a big fat pussy whipped school. What else is there to say? I mean, at this point, we might as well get these people into a fucking mental institution. The fact that they are walking among us is disturbing. These people are the worst kind. Even worse than these fucking, you know, self-righteous vegetarians who believe that they're doing the right thing by becoming vegan, and that if you eat meat, then you're no better than an animal abuser. These people are not asking to be treated as normal human beings. These people are they're asking other folks for society to bend to their ideologies. You know, this is, you know, Barney the Dinosaur logic. You know, I love you, you love me, we are such a happy family. Go to hell, these fuckwits need to go to hell. So, that is all for now. I am the Atheist Gamer. Peace the Gamer.